Jakarta's mass rapid transit is one of the grand initiatives brought up by the government of Indonesia to transform how transportation is run within the capital city of Indonesia. It was first proposed way back in 2006 when public transportation was mainly run across the use of TransJakarta, a bus rapid transit system. Since then, the need for a more rapid and efficient system became more necessary, hence paving the way for a railway. This embarked the first phase of the construction known as the North-South Line, a 15.7-kilometer-long service starting from Bundaran High Station and heading all the way to Lebak Bulus Grab Station, the same place where it holds its train depot. Each of these 13 stations has unique traits within them. Some of them are elevated, and some of them are kept underground. The initial operation of Jakarta MRT has already been operating since its inception way back on the 24th of March 2019, and it has thus far brought in a myriad of increased productivity across the working-class population, and also improved the flow of traffic within Jakarta, a notorious scheme that needs to be fixed as soon as possible. The daily ridership was estimated to be around 40,000, after it recorded 7.2 million during the first semester of 2022. The expected capacity, however, is that it can handle as many as 212,000 passengers daily, which may suggest that the railway is underperforming. Currently, the Jakarta MRT is being run by 16 six-car MRTJ 1000 series train sets, where each set is capable of reaching over 100 kilometers of maximum speed. These rolling stocks were built by a Japanese firm known as Nippon Sharyo, a company known for manufacturing the best rolling stocks in the entire world. After the production of Japan's famous Shinkansen to Singapore's MRT EMU and some of the trains used in the United States, it was delivered and finished in 2018 and has also been so far enjoyed by the local and tourist community. The total 16 six-car sets that were ordered would cost the government over 145 billion Indonesian rupiah, or just near 10 million US dollars. The project cost of constructing Jakarta MRT summed up to be about 16 trillion Indonesian rupiah, or about a billion United States dollars. Quite an ambitious and expensive project. This was loaned from Japan's International Cooperation Agency through a 30-year loan at a 0.25% annual interest rate. This loan, however, was used only for the construction of the first phase. Going forward, Jakarta MRT's future is expected to be further expanded as demand rises and as Jakarta's vehicle congestion worsens. This is why the second phase of the North-South line will be to build 7 more stations on top of the 13 and have an extra 5.8-kilometer line. This is expected to finish by around 2025 and 2027. The second phase, on the other hand, has already started its construction, where it would have a budget of 25 trillion Indonesian rupiah, or 1.67 billion US dollars. Further plans have also been announced, but will be enacted by the next decade. The second phase will have a further expansion and have a project budget of 10 trillion rupiah, or 671 million US dollars. This will increase its total stations to 9 and the total line length to be about 11.8 kilometers. Finally, the expansion of the East-West line will be the final line, as announced thus far, and will be finished after the second phase. This will, however, be a larger expansion and will have around 40 stations, equipped with 84 kilometers worth of length. This will travel from West Java and all the way to Banten. The entire project is owned by the government of Jakarta. The marvelous construction of Jakarta MRT has so far brought in not just a myriad of productive use, but more than likely staged Indonesia as amongst the fastest growing destinations for world-class construction and infrastructures. The city itself, which is notoriously known for its traffic, is now staking its way upwards and changing what was old with emergency technologies. The safety embedded across the planning of the project, the necessary surveillance to ward off threats, and even platform screen doors has shown state-of-the-art improvement. The only issue is that the Jakarta MRT may need to increase its daily ridership to enable the entire project to pay itself. Otherwise, it would probably weigh down on the government's loans, which may likely be unnecessary. However, the government has planned that they were seeking to list the entire Jakarta MRT for an initial public offering, meaning they're planning to sell some of its shares to the public. This could easily offset some of the loans that the government took, and also enable the corporation handling the railway to become more independent, which has been proven as a framework to become more innovative. They had reported that they were planning to do it sometime around 2022 to 2023, which is not far away. Anyway, do let us know what you think about this project. Thanks for watching.